Hey everyone, thank you so much for joining us today. You develop a customer-facing application using Visual Studio Code, and you want to ensure users can sign in securely with Microsoft Entra External ID. Then you are in the right place, with some exciting news to share with you. I'm Yoel Horowitz.
And I'm Samiksha Rana, and we both are product managers for the Microsoft Identity product group. In today's video, we will explore the Microsoft Entra External ID extension for Visual Studio Code and show you how you can bootstrap your projects using this extension. As some of you might be aware, that setting up identity in VS Code can be a lengthy process. It often requires switching between writing code, referring to documentation, and configuring resources manually in Microsoft Entra Admin Center. But the VS Code extension simplifies the onboarding process by allowing you to get started in just a few minutes, and that too without leaving your development environment. With the extension, you can quickly set up external ID tenants and configure, customize, and brand the sign-in experiences for your external users. You can also download sample applications of your choice, which the VS Code extension will configure for you. Now let's dive in to see how it works.
The Microsoft Entra External ID extension is available in the Visual Studio Code Marketplace. Start by opening the Visual Studio Code. From the activity bar, select the extensions icon and search for Microsoft Entra External ID. The overview page shows the details about the extension. Before you install it, to stay up to date with the latest features and enhancements, make sure to select the auto update. Then select Install. Once the extension is successfully installed, choose the Microsoft Entra External ID icon from the activity bar. In the Explorer view, under Help and Feedback section, select Open Extension Walkthrough. The first step of the walkthrough provides you with two options to create an external tenant. If you don't have an Azure subscription, you can choose Set up a free trial. It will create a trial tenant valid for 30 days. The other option is Use My Subscription, which will create a tenant within your Azure subscription. Select this option and allow the extension to sign in with your account. A web browser will open where you need to enter your credentials. After you sign in, close the browser. Now back to the Visual Studio Code, select the subscription under which the tenant will be managed. Then from the list of the resource groups, select a resource group where the tenant will be created. Select your country. It will show you the data center where the tenant will be located. In this example, I will select Denmark and the tenant will be created in the Europe data center. Finally, enter a tenant name. This name must be unique and can't be changed later. After you enter a tenant name, hit the Enter button to start the tenant creation process. This process can take several minutes. You can monitor the progress in the notification area. When the tenant is ready, it will appear in the list of tenants in the Manage Resources section. To continue, select the Setup Sign-in for your users in the walkthrough. This step will prepare your tenant to allow users to sign up or sign in. Let's get started and select Setup Sign-in and Branding. If you have existing tenants under your subscription, make sure to select the one you just created. Then select how would you like your users to sign in. There are two options, email and password or email and one-time passcode. For this demo, I will select email and password. Then select the option to customize the branding for your tenant. This is an optional step and you can skip it. To customize the branding for your tenant, select the layout of the sign-in page. Choose the center aligned option. Select a color from the list or start typing a color name, like green. You have the option to upload a logo. If you have a logo, upload it. Otherwise, skip this step. Wait for the configuration to complete and continue to the next walkthrough step. Try out your sign-in experience. Select Run It Now. From the list of tenants, select the one you created and a new web browser will pop up where you can test your configured sign-in experience. The sign-up and sign-in page has the background color, the logo, and the layout you selected. Since it's a new tenant, you don't have any users, so select the option to create a new user account. Enter an email address. It should not be the one you use to create the tenant. Choose another email. As part of the account creation, you will receive a verification code sent to the email, which you need to enter here. Next, enter a password and then re-enter the password. And finally, select Next to create the account. Well done! Your tenant is created and you signed up your first account. Typically, once the user signs in, they are redirected back to your app. However, since you haven't set up an app at this point, you are redirected to jwt.ms instead, where you can view the contents of the token issued during the sign-in process. Now let me hand over to Yoel, who will show you how to set up a pre-configured sample application.
Thank you, Samiksha. From the walkthrough, select the Setup and Run a Sample Application option, and then select Setup Sample Application. Select your tenant, then select the type of the sample application, like .NET Web Application. Select the location on your workstation where the sample application will be saved. Wait for the download to be completed, then a new instance of VS Code will appear with the sample application you selected. You can close the other Visual Studio Code instance. Open the README file and select the preview option. In the README file, you can find information about the prerequisites to run the sample application, how to run it, and the URL of the application, which will be useful if you want to manually set up your own application. To run the application, use the debugger option. And this time, a new web browser should open within the application URL. If not, you can open it manually and enter the URL as specified in the README file. The sample application requires all users to sign in. Therefore, it takes you immediately to the sign-in page. For other sample applications, you may need to select the sign-in link. Select your account and enter the password. A sample application is a starting point of your application development. You can further develop this application by adding your own business logic and functionality. Cool, sign out or close the web browser. In VS Code, open the application settings file. The VS Code extension registers the sample application in Microsoft Entra External ID and configures the application for you. The settings file contains the configuration of the application. Notice your tenant's name appears and the application ID. From the activity bar, select the Microsoft Entra External ID icon. Select a tenant name, and the details of the tenant appear, including the tenant's name that is specified in the application settings file. Select Applications, and then select the Quick Start application. This application has been created for you by VS Code extension when you run the walkthrough. The application registration establishes a trust relationship between Microsoft Entra External ID and your application. Again, it shows the details of the application, including the application ID. You can also get the application details in JSON format, which can be very useful if you use Microsoft Graph API. If you right-click on any element from the menu, like the application, you have several options, like delete the application registration from your tenant. Manage the application in Microsoft Entra Admin Center. This option will open a web browser and take you directly to the application registration, where you have the option to manage the application, like the authentication settings, the certificate or secret of the application, token configuration, API permissions, and more. Return to VS Code. Right-click and choose Open API Documentation. This will direct you to the relevant documentation to explore available options. You can get the details of the user flow that the VS Code extension created for you. The user flow defines the sign-up and sign-in experience like sign-in method available for users, including email and password, one-time passcode, or social accounts from Google or Facebook. And again, right-click will provide you with some options relevant to the user flow. Select the company branding and then select Sign-in UI. It shows the company branding settings of your tenant. You can update the company branding settings. In the menu, you can find more options to get started, like read the Quick Start Guide, configure the sign-in experience, or download another sample application. Under the Help and Feedback, you can run the walkthrough again, learn about the free trial, explore the Developer Center website, view existing issues with the extension, or open a new one. And you're welcome to provide us with some feedback. When you run the walkthrough, you sign in with your account and all the tenants you have access are listed. To sign out, select the profile icon and then select the sign out next to your account. To sign in again, select the sign in to explore your tenant option.
And that brings us to the end of this demo. As you have seen, The Microsoft Entra External ID extension makes it simple to create external tenants, customize sign-in experiences, and set up pre-configured sample applications all from within VS Code. Now, whether you're just exploring or getting started with identity, this extension simplifies the key steps for you. For more information, be sure to check out the extension at VS Code Marketplace at aka.ms/eeid/VS Code or the documentation link below. We would love to hear your feedback, so feel free to share your thoughts as we continue adding new functionalities to the extension.
We're adding more features and capabilities to the Microsoft Entra External ID VS Code extension. So stay tuned and thanks for watching.